Today's discussion is going to be a little bit different. I really don't feel like there's any particularly relevant and big topics to discuss right now, so today we're going to be talking about strange and creepy communities on Roblox. I'm sure this topic sounds like an odd choice, but I can assure you it will be interesting.
Wow, Rika, you're really running out of ideas.
Shut up. The first strange or creepy community that comes to mind will probably be the Arthot community, or Uncanny Valley as some call it. And while those things certainly do fall under this category, they aren't going to be the focus of today's video. I recently came across one community going by the name of Mugen. I think they're far more interesting than the Uncanny Valley community could ever be. The best way I can describe this group would be as an abstract horror project. On the surface, it may just seem like a bunch of edgy kids trying to act scary, but their creations are actually impressive and interesting. They have all kinds of different strange games, although pretty much all of them end with a jump scare that crashes your game. The first game that caught my eye was Vestushig, which translates to loss. The description also has a strange cipher, which can be translated with a key of 19. Even after translating it, there's still some messed up letters you need to fix, so after replacing the letters accordingly, you get the message,
"Push rock onto stone is only that of the thing you do correct in life easiness."
This game is a simple little area with a flashing shiny ball rolling around, and a creepy looking stone with a face on it in the corner. If you touch the shiny ball at any point, you'll be jump scared and your game will crash, as I mentioned before. The Japanese text on the screen roughly translates to,
"Every time I try to help you, the same mistake is made. You are helpless."
What you're actually supposed to do is move the creepy stone onto this little platform. Afterwards, a new platform will appear with a strange symbol on it, and the shiny ball will suddenly let out a big explosion of sparkles while coming to a complete stop. It'll slowly start to speed up again and directly follow you around the map. To complete the game, you need to push the stone onto the newly spawned platform where the symbol is, which will kill the shiny ball and allow you to use the stone to break down this gate. Finally, you need to push it all the way to the temple in the distance, which will activate, a series of confusing events and Japanese text. Again. One last odd detail in Vestushig is that the game actually has a game pass for some reason. The title of the game pass is yet another cipher, which, when translated with a key of 9, becomes an excellent breakdown. It's currently unknown if this pass actually changes anything within the game itself, so if anybody wants to shell out 421 Robux on this, go ahead, I guess, because nobody has bought it yet, as far as I know. Out of curiosity, I sent the creator of Vestushig a message simply saying D's as a dumb joke, and I didn't expect him to respond, but he actually did.
"You did not push wheat wheel onto stone. You are pitiful."
I responded with, "My apologies. What are the significance of the wheat wheel and the stone?" About an hour later, I got the following reply.
"Push rock onto or stones is only good what you do in life laziness. Go to where it is safe, girly boy."
I respond explaining in detail how I followed his instructions and asked if there was any more information he could provide me with. He responds,
"Purpose is to rid, jailbreak, beeism, foresight. I cannot even tell what he did gross. Robloxian High School, Northern Tube, call me Bob. It destroys the core aesthetic charm site has. Before long, Roblox will become undead living. Creature shell that is perfect for a 6-year-old child who does not learn anything from the site unless it has stopped. I talk go to a fat man."
I ask him, "How exactly do you plan on getting rid of these users and games? And in your opinion, why do you think these particular people slash games are going against the aesthetic and charm?" To which he simply replies with,
"DSC."
As a joke, I reply with, "Despacito," and immediately get
"Core"
sent back to me. Not knowing what to respond with, I just say yes, to which he responds with,
"The program, you wheel axle."
Lastly, I made a guess as to what DSC was referring to by asking digital security control and got no response. If you thought that was confusing, well, that's only the tip of the iceberg, because as I mentioned before, they have their own little Roblox group, and it's equally nonsensical. The vast majority of their group wall consists of more garbled up English as well as some garbled up Japanese. One strange pattern I noticed is that all of the posts in Japanese use either the number 821 or 874. I'm not sure what the significance of either of these numbers are, but it's something. Believe me, there are many more strange games to take a look at, so let's check out another one. AXF version history. Right off the bat, you're immediately smacked with these incredibly trippy distortion effects and some ridiculous color correction. The objective in this game is simple enough, although the distortion makes it much more difficult. You're meant to climb up the wall by jumping on these small platforms, and once you reach the top, you're really really not given much. All that can be seen is an endless white, glitchy void, and a little bridge leading up to a sphere. Upon trying to cross the bridge, it'll simply collapse and you'll fall to your inevitable doom, which of course crashes your game. There's a ton of other games I could go over, but the last one I'd like to take a look at is this, which roughly translates to "It's beautiful." This game is the most normal looking out of everything we've talked about, but don't let that fool you. The main thing you're going to notice is the gigantic wall that seemingly extends infinitely. Right in front of you is a big arrow pointing to your left. But again, don't be fooled, as going all the way to the left end of the wall will lead to your certain demise in the form of a predictable jump scare and game crash. If you're a real intellectual, then you'll know to go to the right instead. To the right of the wall is a little stone that you can jump on to get over the wall. Let's back up a bit though. You may also notice this suspicious dot out in the distance to the right. If you didn't, then I guess you're not very observant. Approaching this dot will reveal that it's yet another rock with a strange cipher on it. Translating this cipher with a key of 22 will reveal this phrase, which is Latin for the heavens. Back to the wall, jumping over it will lead you to an ominous looking temple with not much in it aside from a pillar with an even more ominous looking symbol on it. Clicking on this symbol will create some sparkles, turn the lighting down to absolute darkness, and crash your game. I think that's where I'm gonna call it quits for now, because there's just too much to put all in one video, but there's still a lot to be discovered, and I'll be putting some useful links in the description to help you decode their messages and try out their games for yourself. I highly encourage you to go show them some support by playing and liking their games, because this kind of thing doesn't show up on Roblox too often, and I'm glad they're putting a unique spin on it instead of taking a really generic creepypasta approach. If you do decide to check these games out though, either mute or turn down your Roblox volume for the sake of your own safety, because let me tell you,
it can get pretty loud.
As always, let me know what you think, suggest things for future discussions, blah blah blah. Bye.
Uh-oh, this is not a drill, guys. Someone in the Mugen group just posted a YouTube video in the wall, and they have a YouTube channel now, and it's a really weird video. I'll link it in the description. But maybe if we're lucky, this might be turning into, like, a proper web series, and that'd be really cool. You know, I'm excited to see where this goes.
This is not a drill.